Believe it or not, we're actually up in a treehouse right now, and right here they're making this splendid meal.
This is today's main dish, using the ingredients caught from and found in the surrounding rainforest. It starts with a layer of dry sago tree starch, then a sprinkling of pika, a type of edible clay material.
It tastes like clay.
Oh yeah, sure.
Dry sand.
The practice of eating earth or soil-like substances is nearly universal around the world in tribal and traditional rural societies. Clay minerals have beneficial microbial effects, protecting the stomach against toxins, parasites, and pathogens.
And then they're putting on the fern, then they put on all the sago worms from the tree, and then all this kind of fern right here.
Yes.
And then more on top. So this is kind of like a giant cake or something.
Giant pizza or something.
Okay. They're gonna put all these super hot rocks on here. Now they're gonna bundle all these leaves. It's like its own self-contained oven. And all of this is just stuff they cut and collected from right around here.
Yeah,
so cool. Oh, they're gonna put it on the fire. Oh, wow. 45, 35 minutes on the fire, and then we're gonna bust that open and eat it.
What is that? You said the dry one. You will try.
What? The dry one? Oh no, it's a sago worm.
The sago worms that didn't make it into the main dish are put directly onto the fire and treated as an appetizer of sorts.
Smoky. Kind of tastes like grilled chicken. I think as it's like singed, it's a little like charcoal flavor. It sounds like they're murdering a pig now. They're not. Turn it off.
Throw it off.
I'll throw Coming up next, you thought that was it, but what about the beetles from today? They're right here.
The beetles we caught earlier from the same sago tree were dispatched for easier transport.
Sorry.
You're dead.
We're gonna eat you for dinner.
All of them are dumped onto the hot cinders to cook through.
Cheers. Oh, it just tastes like soot from the fire. I mean, it's on there. It's like a little bitter.
Can I get you one?
Yeah. Not bad. That's pretty good. Don't fall in the fire. Okay, I was helping you. He's like, I got it. I'm already two, I'm fine. Boom! Oh! So this is finished cooking. We're all gonna join together, and I don't know which way we're bringing it. I'll get right there. They kind of cook everything this way, whether they've got some pork or some tree kangaroo. Wow, look at that. That vibrant red-orange color is from the sago. It looks kind of like a pizza, except for this pizza has worms in it. Oh, it's super hot, but he's ripping it apart with his hand. She says, no, use this, be smart. And he says, yes, I agree, that is a good idea. Oh, and then this is how they prepare it. This is like one serving right here. Thank you.
After a portion of sago pizza is handed to each housemate, they retreat into their own personal space to eat.
Inside, oh, big sago reveal. That fern that we saw in the jungle earlier has kind of cooked down. It's kind of a mush. And then that is mixed with all the sago. And then there's just little chunks of worm throughout. I don't know. Everyone just kind of rips it up and eats pieces. I'm going to try it. This is sick, yo. This is so good. This is so weird. It's become this really gummy, chewy texture. And then the greens, the ferns have broke down. They're soft now. Earthy and grassy. It tastes like the jungle. It's about what you would expect. I mean, look at that. There's a giant sago worm right there in my next bite. Man, you really gotta chew the heck out of it, though. That is out there, man. I must say, this is one of the most special moments of my life. Being so far away, a place we had to trek hours to through the rain, to finally being in this treehouse, their home, where they have a fire inside, they're cooking food that we caught today. It's so refreshing. It's so cool to see something this new, this different. It's beautiful. I love it. And it really, I don't know. It tastes like the jungle. Got a little bit of everything in there. Little sago, little worm, little greens, and that's Papua in a pizza.